Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm uploading about the LangChain and the different use cases. We will look at the code understanding. As usual, I create an output in Colab Pro, and I will upload later on this notebook to the repository, and you can review it at your own convenience. And today we will be using Colab Pro. We will be using as well today, or I will give you an introduction on Llama CPP and the GGUF models, and we will use LangChain, as you can imagine, and a model which is going to be called Llama 13 billions, and you will see how it's possible to load in a small GPU. It's i100, but for this model, which without any quantization, is around about 14 gigabytes of file. We can upload it in memory and had a reasonable performance and also a reasonable outcome. We will use as well OpenAI models like in other occasions, and today I will just make an introduction of the Llama CPP. We will cover the topic in another series of videos, and for those that are following my channel, probably is you will see that the Llama CPP is something similar to what we already covered with Olama. Olama sounds to me that is a little bit more advantage in terms of the number of models that they are already had on the framework. Llama CPP had a lot of models as well, and support a lot of languages or integrate with a lot of languages. We will cover this now in a couple of minutes when we are reviewing the notebook. As usual, we install the libraries we need. We mount the drive, and first of all, to install Llama CPP, we need to clone this repository. We enter on the repository and we make, we using the command make for those that work with C++. This is the way that we create the binary. Just to tell you that Llama CPP is a binary, is an application in C++. So we need to build the binary, and then on install the bindings to Python. This tool was created by Gerganov, and also create the GGML library. Sorry, is here GGML, and last improvement of the library is introducing the GGUF format, which is an improvement of the original one that was GGML. You can take a look here to the repository. Also, there is very good documentation. So this is a C++ application. We need to compile it. So, and there is as the description saying, an efficient library to do inference in, as they say, variety of hardware. Here we are going to work today with Linux, the Linux that come with Google Colab and with an NVIDIA GPU. But the library or the application is ready to work with other architectures, which make it a lot very flexible. Llama support all the models that you see here. There is a number of them. Compiling or using this framework is again, also Olama is able to use the models prepare and compile with in GGUF format or GGML. Again, today everything is being moved to GGUF because had a number of advantages to do with that, and you will see here now in a second why this is possible, because yeah, the models are smaller and they allow you to use cheaper hardware to do inference of these models that some of them are really big. So in my machine I cannot run it because this model, as you will see here, I pass you as well some links of the these two users. Well, one user is the own Llama, the original CodeLlama 13 billion HF, which as you can see here, they had all the shape tensors in total, probably 26 gigabytes. So in original, it's started to be complicated to do even inference when not doing a fine tuning of this model. Is very complicated to do with just a GPU, even being a 800, sorry. And then on this other link is the block. This user has already convert the original 13 billion strat to the format GGUF. As you see here, there is multiple versions of the same model. Today we will use this one. So what I did is download this model to my local local Google Drive, and I did it using the terminal I had available in Colab Pro, and replicating the model. You can follow these instructions to download the model to local. In this case, you will download all the versions. If you want just to download one of the models, you can simply download here with a link and using Bget, something like that, and download it again using Bget, WGET, or do it like I did it with GIT. Exactly. At the end, you just need this this model, one of these files, the Llama CPP binary installed in your machine. So compiling the binary takes a while, around about 5 minutes. Then on you install the bindings, the Python bindings. It's a Python library in this case, and here I'm going to download as well the LangChain repository. This is the repository I will use to in combination with a vector database like to provide context to our LLM. So we are specializing the LLM and LangChain in this specific code. So apart of what the model is able to do itself, we are giving all this code. This is Python code I will show you now, as context to answer questions, or we use as well in a, or to be used in a conversational chatbot. So I clone the repo. Just simply download with git clone the repository. And here what we do, continue, we just using these two libraries from LangChain community, generic loader and language parser. The generic loader, let's review this before. Language parser is a library from community LangChain. It's a specialized class that understand all these languages that you see here. You see here is a variety of them. And I suppose that we can here. I'm not 100% sure. I need to read indeed the documentation, but I'm not really sure that we can mix different languages. So here, in this example, it's really simple. We are going to just specialize in Python and specifically in the LangChain library. So I will take a look to this and post it later back on the repo if there is a possibility to use the loader. The loader, the generic loader, is just loading a repository and reading uploading the files that you specify in the suffixes, and then on is creating LangChain documents for you, PY files in this case. As you see here, you can use not only Python, you can use Perl, Ruby, Rust, Scala. There is a variety of languages that you can use. this case there is as well developing in Python mostly, so we use we load the Python files, and then on Tuesday here after loading the documents we had the license documents with page content and metadata. In this case the metadata just contains the constant Python that can also yield the library and also the source of the file. No? Here is just here from Anthropic, that this is probably a file that is interacting with Anthropic models. Then we use a text recursive character text splitter. This is a text loader. What we have here on a document, we just create a different split the documents into chunks of a size. Here we are using 2000. To be honest, this is something I just translate from the launching documentation. To me it's a little bit small, 500 tokens, some cases a little bit small, but well, it's something that we can play with. Either to extend it to 3,000, 4,000 characters, depending. Also, not very sure if all the languages had the same style guidelines like Python. So probably somebody who is familiar with the others, I could say something about C++ or C or C Sharp or Java, but some languages I never work with them, Ruby or Rust. I just see some code and then I don't know if they follow similar coding guidelines like Python. Per, I know it's very, it's all language already. Well, all saying that probably all scripting language, and they used to generate very long script files. No, but again, if somebody can get some ideas about this, well, happy to read it on the comments. Here we charge the key to work with OpenAI. We generate embeddings, and we upload it to the Chroma Vector Store. You can take a look. We already comment this vector database, simple one, make the job, and for what we are doing here, more than enough. So for other purposes, you may need or you may want to use Pinecone or Neo4j or Face from Facebook or Meta4. Chroma is again is a vector database, is doing the job, and here, yeah. We upload, we create the embeddings using OpenAI, we upload it to Chroma, and we will use MMR as a metric to find the closest documents, the closest vectors in the database of a given text, as we will see now. Now we create an LLM. We are going to create a conversational retrain chain and also with a buffer, and the LLM that we will use GPT-4. We pass we create the buffer for the history of our conversation, and we create the QA chain with our LLM, the retriever, which is the database and the memory. This is an agent. Here we have created the agent, so the vector database as retriever is create an agent that we can use later on to provide context to the LLM and together with the memory, case that you continue with the conversation. This is providing context to our QA agent to get you a correct answer. Here we just formulate a question, and you can see here the answer, quite detailed. Obviously, we are working with GPT-4. GPT-4 had a long window context, and then on the answer is according to the size of the window context of the LLM. Here we make another example with three different questions, and also again the quality that provides GPT-4 is very good. Obviously, it's a commercial LLM, and then on we had to pay for that. But yeah, now we see the same examples with Llama CPP. So once we have the creative binary, so here also I give you some links also to the GGML library. This the library that developed as well Gerganov. And this is the, how to say, the base of the Llama CPP. You can see here the features, support quantization, different optimizers. So, and this is orientated to do inference. So integrations with multiple models, and again, yeah, quite interesting. I also give you here a link to compare something that write pros and cons of using the original GGML and or the GGUF, the latest one that was published last year. And then practically now everything is refactored or transferred to this format, and the original GGML is starting to be deprecated. Yeah. As you know, 8 months here in LLMs is kind of a decade. No, it's here everything goes very fast. So yeah. Again, probably you will not see GGML models very soon, and this probably even they will be improving. No. The state of the art now, the status is that we will use, as well now you will see, we will use GGUF in our example. You have here the documentation. Take a look and read the documentation to understand all the details. So again, Llama CPP and GGML was developed by Georgi Gerganov. And also here you have the links to the Llama CPP and also to the Tensor Library. Some interesting stuff they provide as well is this HTTP server for Llama CPP, created as well in C++. So we can take a look in a separate video to understand what they provide. They are possible to use in Windows, in a Docker, so interesting. That stuff. So let's go to here. We had a class as well in LangChain to work with Llama CPP. We do some imports. The class you just instantiated with the path to the binary file. And as you see here, we just pass the path. We say the number of GPUs that we are gonna use. And we use verbose, and also you need to use floating 16 crew just to do this. In the documentation there is much more other parameters that we will not cover here, and this is the very basic way to load the model and create the object and to create the LLM in this case. And well, you just make a question here again. And also you can see the answer. Pretty limited right now. Well, the question was pretty simple as well. To create something in bash, usually the scripts usually are not very long. So there is probably not. So if you see here list of text files, the answer is completely correct. It's not the... The only thing that we can limit here and remove some of the trust that is introducing the model, but well, I leave it to you. You can play around as well with the, once you have the binary created, you can play around with the and see the there is ways to like that. Now we will create a QA chain with the same model. We create a template. And we just create the retriever, the documents according to the question that we make. How can I initialize a React agent? This is using obviously LangChain. We get the documents, the similar documents in total 8 by default. the parameter that we set at above. We create the chain with our LLM, with our prompt and the type stuff, and we just simply invoke here the LLM and return the language. Total 68 seconds, which is not bad. It's a 13 billion model, and keep that in mind. We are working with it's not a domestic GPU, obviously, it's a A100, but just bear in mind that every time that at least the first time you need to load the model in memory with the binary, and then on the first call that you make to the chain, is going to take minutes after you have the model in the GPU with the correct transformation. The second calls are going to take less time, the second queries. And you see here, finally, the response of the LLM. Again, like we did before, here we had a limited default in our answer. We can improve as well this response, passing some other additional parameters to the invoke of the chain, to the like number of the min tokens or max tokens, and had a probably more large, because the model allowed us to have a longer, a large answer that we are receiving here. We received in any case only the response, so this also in the chain you can pick, you can modify this to your convenience. And that's all. I hope that you like. We will cover the topic Llama CPP in another video, one or two that we will get, especially to how to do this installation in a Windows environment, which is possible. And then see what we can do in a conventional desktop. Or I suppose that we will not be able to load the 13 billion. If you look at here, we had 13 billion is 7.87 gigabytes file, which in my machine is not gonna work. Because I had a GPU with 4 gigabytes, so but the same, but probably we had the same for the 7 billion model. I know probably let's take a look to these guys. Code Llama 70 billions, yeah, probably too much. We have here a lot much more. Okay. Let's check it. Yeah. Something wrong with my internet. Let me 1 second. Yeah, exactly. We had models 7 billions. Let's take a look to the instruct. 4 bit precision, this case. And yeah, the model is safe tensors, but this is not format GGUF. Okay, I will try to find it if we had a GGUF version of the 7 billions, and we will make a video just to test if the model is able to run in using Llama CPP in a conventional GPU. I suppose that most of the people who have a GPU on the local computer have 4 gigabytes at least. I don't expect to have more than that. That's my case in any case. So that is what I can do. It's not this example, as you know, we use the A100 in a Colas Pro. You can replicate it there. I think that this model is also it's possible to use it simply at T4, because here we don't use the 40 gigabytes for sure. But one of the particularities we had with this model, with these tools, is the once you finish the inference, after some timeout or some time, the model is how to say removed from memory. So if you I don't know what is the default time. We can take a look as well. But once the model is removed from memory, you need to offload it again, and it's again you pass through the cycle to offload the model, transform it to the offload it to the GPU. I mean, and then this takes some time after it's done. So if you are in a cycle of doing some queries and analyzing the response, this is going to be fast, but after a while the model will be removed from the GPU, clean the GPU in any case, and if you continue with the conversation you will need to do this again, which had again a delay. Okay, that's all. I hope you like it, and as I used to say, if you like the video, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it. Thank you very much. See you soon.